Hi, I'm Ken Johnson. I'm Executive Dean of the Heritage College. I'm here in Dublin, Ohio, where we're doing a golf tournament today to raise money for students. And I have John Peters and Breanna Santoso with me to have a little conversation about what it's like to be a medical student. So, you know, part of what I was wondering is, you got a year under your belt here right now, and what are you looking forward to for this coming year?
Yeah, I'm really excited for this coming year. I think I have a lot more confidence going into second year after navigating first year and having that under my belt. I have a really good study buddy group, and so having good community is really good.
Oh, awesome. Well, John, you know what I was thinking? A year ago, you were walking through the doors for the first time. Any surprises?
You know, I think the biggest surprise that I found was how much that we can learn in such a short amount of time. And that's what I'm most looking forward to. You know, we keep on learning and, keep getting one step closer to being a doctor.
Yeah. So I'm wondering, what have you enjoyed learning most in medical school so far?
I really enjoyed diving deeper into the pathology. So in undergrad, we learned a lot of the basic science foundation. And I love being able to apply what we know to a clinical perspective and just tie in all of the treatment, all the clinical manifestations, and disease pathology.
Oh, excellent. So John, I'm wondering, as you're looking forward to this year, you know, anything you're excited about, anything you're nervous about?
I think, I'm both really excited and both really nervous about board studying and board prep. So we take our boards here next summer, and I'm really excited about it. Going to do a lot of preparation, but I know we can do it.
Yeah. You know, medical school can be a stressful time, and I'm wondering, you know, what do you do to relax and blow off steam a little bit?
Yeah, well, golf. I think it's really important to find that balance and take time off. You can't study 24/7. You're going to be burnt out. You're not going to be efficient in your studying. So I always try to incorporate sports into my weekly routine and then hang out with friends. But one piece of advice that I have is volunteer in something that you're passionate about. So for example, I volunteer for a group of girls, and every Monday evening, I just really looked forward to, after those exams, I just go and have these conversations with these girls and build relationships with them, and it just really allowed me to decompress.
Oh, that's excellent. You know, medical school, you could study 24/7, and someone once said to me that it's really hard to take care of others if you're not taking care of yourself. And I think of our motto of, you know, kind of care leads here, and you have to start from taking care of yourself, and you do a better job of taking care of others, because you could really, you could work 24/7 and still feel like you have more work to do. Yeah. So I know for a fact that we have 250 students that are feeling a little bit nervous right now about to start medical school. Any advice for them?
You know, I think my biggest piece of advice is there's going to be a lot of people that say that they have the one true way, but the reality is you got to find your one true way. And that just takes a lot of practice. You know, there's going to be ups and downs, but that's okay. Yep. And that's what the entire Heritage College staff is there for. That's what your second years and third years and fourth years are there for. So we're all in it together, and we'll all figure it out together.
Yeah. Excellent. Great. Well, I have to say, I've really enjoyed my conversation with both of you. I feel blessed to have the best faculty, staff, and students in the nation, and you are shining star examples of that. So thanks for everything that you do, and thanks for spending a little bit of time with me today.
Thank you.
Yep. Thank you.